Hello students, welcome in our series Parts of Speech. In last lecture we have discussed overview about parts of speech. You all know we have 8 parts of speech. Now we will discuss one by one our all parts of speech. Today in our second lecture we are going to learn about verb. What is verb? How many types of verb? And how can we use verb? Let's see. Students, you know that verb is a very good part of a sentence. Verb can describe tense. Without verb we cannot recognize tense and we cannot make sentence. So verb is a heart of a sentence. A verb is a word which shows or says about the state, position or action of the subject in a sentence. What is verb? Verb is a word which shows or says about the state, position and action. Which word shows action, state, position of the subject? It is called verb. We have the types of verb. First one is state and action verb. Sometimes we can say state verb, a stative verb, or action verb is a dynamic verb. We can use a dynamic in place of action and stative verb in place of a state verb. So what is state verb and what is action verb? Action verb shows physical action. Action verb shows a physical action means you can know the action, physical action. Like I am teaching you, so you can see I am doing a physical action. He drinks tea. Drink is, you can show drink. How can he drink? So it shows a physical action, so it's called a action verb. While state verb express situation and position. State verb, you cannot see a physical action in a state verb. There is a state verb shows you position or a situation. I have a chalk. I have a chalk. In this sentence you cannot see any action, but you can see a verb have. So have is a state verb. I am a teacher. I am a teacher. In this sentence you cannot see any action, but you can see a position. I am a teacher. So am is a state verb. Let's see the example. He drinks milk every day. Here you can see drinks. So some physical action, so it is called action verb. You know the why we put S here, because it's a simple present tense, and in simple present tense when we use third person singular, at that time we put S or ES with verb. In second sentence, I have a heavy bag. In this sentence, have is verb, but here you cannot see any physical action, so you can say that have is state verb. Julie likes stories. You can see like is verb, but it is state verb. Why state verb? You cannot see Julie likes stories, so it is a state verb. You cannot see physically, so it is a state verb. Student, in English we make a common mistake. This is that state verbs can't be used in ing form. We cannot use ing form with a state verb. We cannot say Julie is liking stories. So keep in mind and avoid mistake and write properly. Not in mind that state verb can't be used in ing form. Keep in mind this point, student. Sometimes we make a common mistake in this verb. So we learn about what is state verb and what is action verb. Our second type is main verb, helping verb, we can say auxiliary also. What is helping verb? Its name shows us, helping verb helps in sentence. We have three helping verbs, be, do and have. Be, do and have are three main helping verb. We can divide in inner tense also. Here in table you can see be, do and have. In present tense M is are. In past tense the form of be is was and were. And future tense in be will be and shall be. In do present tense we use do does. In past tense we use did. In future tense we use will, shall plus do. The form of have, in present tense we use have and has. In past we use had. In future we use will, shall plus have. Students, sometimes students make mistake when we say what is the to be form of future tense, they only say shall and will. But no, the future tense, the form of be is shall be and will be. We can use this form to make a sentence whenever you want to make a negative sentence, question sentence, you use this form. Let's see, Khushi is reading now. Here you can say, see that is a helping verb and read is a main verb. Is helping to show the continue present tense. So is help us to show the tense. If we want to say Khushi was reading then, at that time was shows here continue past tense. If you want to make a negative sentence, you can use helping verb Khushi isn't reading now. Otherwise Khushi wasn't reading then. Likewise Mrunal doesn't read a book. Here we use does as a helping verb to show simple present tense. If you want to use a past tense, simple past tense, you use did. Runal didn't read a book. If you want to make a question sentence, you can use did Runal read a book. Have you completed your work? Here have is used as a helping verb. Have you completed? It shows a perfect present tense. Here have is used for to describe, yes, perfect present tense, and completed is a past participle of complete. We have a car. Here have is a state verb and here is used have is using for a main verb. So student, helping verb and main verb. Main verb shows you action, helping verb helps to describe tenses. And then modal verb. What is modal verb? Models help us to express mood or attitude. Modal verbs help us to express our mood, our attitude. You might learn online. You might learn. If I say you learn online, I cannot describe my possibility, but if I add you might learn online, that is a possibility. My friend win the match. If I remove can, it doesn't show ability. If I add can, it shows ability. My friend can win the match. The ability of friend to win the match we can see by using can. Yes, good. You must not smoke. Advise, you smoke. It doesn't show any mood, attitude. If I add you mustn't smoke, it shows advice. We have so many modal verbs like can, could, should, would, must, may, might, etc. Students, we have discussed about state, action verb, main and helping verb. It helps to indicate tense and modal verbs. Now we will learn about regular and irregular verb. What is regular verb and what is irregular verb? We use regular or irregular verb to make tense. Students, we use regular and irregular verb to make tense. We have five forms of verb. Let's see which are five forms. First one, infinitive, present, past, past participle, and ing form. To open is infinitive. To open is present form. Kya hoga? Open ya to opens. You know, when we have the subject third person singular, at that time we use s or es with a verb. Past form opened, and past participle is opened, and ing form is opening. Go, goes, your go, past form is went and past participle is gone, and ing form is going. See the difference in between opened. In past, in past participle form, we used ed. It is called regular verb. When we use d or ed using rule and the verb form are same, it is called regular verb. In short, when we use a d or ed, it is called regular verb. But here you can see went and go. Here we don't use ed in both form. Both are different. We have no rule to remember past and past participle. We have to mug up or read many times, then we can remember this word. It is called irregular verb. It's a to be, am is, are. Past form is was, where. We learn these in helping verb also. The past participle form of to be is been, and ing form is being. So regular and irregular verb, when we use d or ed, it is called regular verb. And when we don't use d or ed and we have to mug up or read the verb many times, it is called irregular verb. Next is transitive and intransitive verb. What is transitive and what is intransitive? Students, the common mistake when we make sentence in, we use the transitive or intransitive verb. What is transitive? Transitive verb always takes an object. Madhav kicked. When we read the sentence, Madhav kicked, you have a question, what kick? Madhav kicked the ball. The sentence is complete. Without object, this sentence is incomplete. So kick is called transitive verb. Transitive verb needs an object. Without object, we cannot make a sentence with a transitive verb. In English, we make a common mistake. Sometimes we use a transitive verb without an object, and our meaning, no, we cannot clear our meaning. So hope you can understand what is transitive verb. When the verb need an object, it is called transitive verb. How can you know? By asking question with what and whom. What kicked? What did Madhav kick? The ball. Whom? I gave you. Whom do I give? So, whom. When you ask the question by what and whom, you can got transitive verb. Hit, give, carry, climb, make, all are transitive verb. Next is intransitive verb. Intransitive verb doesn't take an object. An old man laughed loudly. Old man laughed loudly. What loudly? We cannot say. What did old man laugh? We cannot say. So intransitive verb doesn't take any object, and we have not necessary to put an object. Cry, sleep, laugh, run, sit, stand. If I say I sit, you cannot ask me a question, what you sit, what do you sit? Okay, this is the transitive and intransitive verb. When we use transitive verb, at that time we have to use an object. Remember this point, that when you use transitive verb in your sentence, you have to always write an object. Without object, you cannot write transitive verb. Hope you can understand the difference between transitive and intransitive verb, and what is transitive and what is intransitive. We learn four types of verb here. First, we learn state and action verb. Second, main and helping with modal. Third, regular and irregular. Fourth, transitive and intransitive. We learned two common mistakes in English. First one, we cannot use ing with state verb. And second common mistake is, when we use transitive verb, we have to use an object. Without object, we should not use transitive verb. Hope you can understand the what is verb and how can we use verb in our language, and we can make our language very effective when you write essays, application and writing portion. Thank you.